Get your latest iChristine merch at crowdmade.com/iChristine. And be sure to check out the new limited edition Animal Crossing themed iChristine merch. Don't go chasing water bottles. Link down below. Hey buddies, it's your girl iChristine, and today we are checking out a Wolfie Chew video. This is 1 year with our mochi. Link for this video is in the description box below for you to check out. Now let's get started.
April 8th was a very important day. Mm-hmm. Happy birthday to you. Oh. Happy birthday to you.
I like that bird. So cute. Mochi.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh. Yay. So cute.
Before we get into the video, oh, Mochi has something that she wants to say.
What?
What? Mochi says, hit the subscribe button and turn the bell notifications.
Of course.
So that you never miss an upload from me.
I keep leaning in as if I could hear Mochi talk to me.
On with the video. Yeah, April 8th was a while ago now, but...
May 8th is my birthday.
This, it's been 1 year exactly since the day we actually brought Mochi home.
Aww.
So what better time to make this video? Other than on your actual birthday, I guess? Of course, we did celebrate on the actual day.
Okay,
that's
good.
I actually wanted Mochi to have like a little puppy party with Jordan's family's dogs because of Coda's birthday is 3 days later.
Time for
so
cake.
I thought they could have like a shared thing, but because of social distancing at the time, we weren't able to do that.
Right.
It being so cute. Aww. But either way, I still wanted it to be a special day for her because it's her first birthday.
She's so cute.
Her first birthday ever.
So cute.
It's the first celebration she's had in her life.
What's happening?
Other than her first Christmas and Halloween, of course, which were also really cute. Aww. But birthdays are different.
Yeah.
Mochi, today's your birthday. Mochi, you're 1 year old.
Baby, hey. So cute.
I can't believe you're only one. You're still so fresh to the world. We've had
from being just one
through her
makes me think of my baby
stage. Look at her little eyebrows. And now to fully grown potato. I can't believe it's already been a whole year since we got Mochi. Time just flew by and she grew up so fast.
Time does fly.
Look at her when we first got her. Look at this little puppy.
Aww.
She was just this little potato and was the size of my hand and was just such a little derpy girl. Okay, I guess that last part hasn't really changed too much.
Oh, really?
But she's really gotten her own little personality now and she makes us laugh every day with the silly little things that she does. For example, everyone who knows Mochi knows that she has a Donald Duck mode.
Okay.
By this, I mean that when she's playing, she makes these growling sounds that sound a lot like Donald.
Oh, really?
It's actually weird.
Yeah, I've heard dogs do this before.
And while we're on the subject of birds, Mochi loves them.
She
doesn't just want to chase them. Anytime she sees one, she just wants to go up to it and stare at it. Like she's completely mesmerized.
Oh, so she's interested.
I think she's still too new to understand them.
What are you doing?
A little while ago, Mochi also finally became old enough to sleep on our bed
instead
of sleeping on her bed in the bathroom at night. And even though there's so much space on the bed, she always sleeps in the exact same spot. Right on top of me. It's a good thing she's so small.
I thought it was going to be in between them.
Bigger, she'd probably still want to sleep there, and I'd just get crushed every night.
Oh, by this big old bear.
And then as soon as I wake up, she starts wriggling over to my face like a little worm and starts doing these really loud, exaggerated yawns. Because she just wants me to get out of bed and give her breakfast. She's done yawns
that's so
like these
cute.
Ever since she was a baby. We kind of encouraged it a lot because we thought it was so cute. And now, a lot of the time she does it for attention.
Bet they're looking
only
now.
Every day is playtime for Mochi.
Of course.
She's not very good at telling when she's starting
asleep.
To get tired or if she just refuses to start getting tired.
Like
but she will use 100%
like,
of her energy until she has nothing left and she'll just fall asleep on the spot. A lot of the time she'll fall asleep with toys in her mouth literally just because of she kept playing until she couldn't keep going.
Oh my gosh.
You're crazy. She also makes the derpiest little faces when she's playing. Like, why?
She is excited.
Of course. course, she loves chasing things, mm-hmm. mostly her tail. Oh. She'll also pretty much play with anything that can fit in her mouth. Look at her with this big stick. Look at this ferocious little
Oh, I like their doggo. Planters.
Charge, Mati! We discovered not long ago that if we shine a light on the ground, she'll chase it
just like cats.
She actually goes crazy for it. It's really funny. Look how fast she goes. She's having so much fun. Yeah, Mati, show that light who's boss.
I wonder why it is that cats and dogs do that.
Which finally started growing some strawberries.
Oh, that's good.
I was so excited because I love strawberries. Mm-hmm. But then one day I looked at it and realized that all of the strawberries were gone.
Oh, did she eat them?
It was confusing, but it didn't stay a mystery for long because it turned out that Mochi had actually eaten them all.
All of them.
She just went out there on her own one day and smelt something good and I guess was just like, I'm gonna have a little try of this. And then she just ate the whole thing.
Oh my goodness. Hopefully they're it's okay, right? Okay.
We got lucky in the fact that she hasn't chewed a lot of our things up.
That's good.
She has destroyed 2 dog beds and a couple of my tablet pens too. Mm. Luckily, I always have spares.
That's good.
A question that I get a lot about Mochi is, does she know any tricks? Mm. And yes, she actually knows about 20 tricks now.
Oh, that's good.
The first trick that she learned, of course, was sit.
All right.
And now she knows a lot more advanced ones.
Okay, not as crazy as this. Okay.
My favorite ones.
Oh. So cute! Oh, you're adorable! Oh, this is so good! Oh, so cute!
Of course, I wanted.
She's
to
really good.
On her birthday, so
I love the high five.
I went online and found a recipe for a pupcake.
Okay.
I just love saying pupcake.
That is cute.
So I decided to make one for her, and also one for Coda, since her birthday was 3 days later.
Okay.
It was mostly just oats and peanut butter, but what more could a dog want?
Do they like
oats and peanut butter?
And look how good
they
butter?
Came out.
Okay.
I felt like Link in Breath of the Wild.
Oh, when he's like, and then there's food.
Too, because it smelled good, but I resisted.
Okay.
And then we got the little pupcake and put one little candle on it because one is all that she needs. Aww. So she's pretty mellow when it's just the two of us singing happy birthday. Mm-hmm. But when there's more people, she gets very overexcited. And
oh,
seems
wow.
like she just doesn't know how to react.
I think, yeah, overstimulated.
She wants to howl, but she hasn't
how to,
do that yet. Aww. She's trying to sing with us. It's so cute. I was half expecting Mochi to pull a Kirby move on me and just inhale the whole thing.
Oh, really?
But she ate slowly, which was surprising.
That's good.
She really loves her food.
That's good.
And then, of course, her present, which she also loved. Mm-hmm. I know that some people find it kind of weird to celebrate your dog's birthday.
I don't.
I don't know. It's something that I'm always going to want to do.
Yeah.
I want Mochi to have her special day every year. It was a really cute day, and I'm happy that she's happy.
Mm-hmm.
It's only been 1 year since we brought this little potato into our
life. I love that she calls her a little
so
potato.
It brings us happiness and laughter every day.
Aww.
What would the world be without dogs?
Aww.
If you enjoy this video,
Yoshi.
Please be sure to subscribe and turn on the Yoshi bell notifications
Mochi.
To all so that you never miss an upload.
Aww.
If you want to see even more pictures and videos of Mochi, then be sure to come follow me on my Twitter and Instagram. They are linked
she
below.
She is so adorable.
I also have a TikTok now, so be sure to come follow me on that as well. I'll be posting a lot. And thank you guys for watching. Bye!
Aww. This was just a very, very, very adorable video. That's what this was. To see this adorable puppy. I don't think there's anything wrong with celebrating pet birthdays. I think I said happy birthday the first year. But after, like when I got my cats. But after that, life was so crazy that I never did anything for them. So I don't think it's weird that people do things for their pets for birthdays. I think it's fine. I think it's completely fine. I think this was super adorable. It would have been adorable to have like a puppy party. the thought of that is just absolutely cute. And super adorable of a thought. And their puppy is so freaking cute. The tricks I've not seen, because I don't watch dog shows and I don't have a dog. So to know all of the different things that a dog could possibly know or possibly do is not something I'm akin to, right? So seeing this little doggy do all these different moves and did the high five and the leg thing, I'm like, oh my goodness, she's so good. I feel like I could probably like I would probably be okay. When it comes to dogs, if they have too much energy, it makes me nervous. I've seen dogs like jump and bite and yip at people and things like that. And that makes me a little bit nervous. It makes me uncomfortable. So seeing a dog as well trained as that, it makes me feel like I could be comfortable and they could tell her stop or sit and she'd be okay. I would like to do some of these tricks with her, like the walking between the legs, the high five, I think would be super duper cute. It makes me really, really, really want to get a puppy. Before I got pregnant, I was on a serious puppy, a very serious puppy journey to get a puppy. Like, I even tried to get one online because I specifically wanted a Pomsky. And then when that turned out to be a scam, I didn't pay them, don't worry, and they didn't have my address or information. When I figured out it was a scam, I went to like puppy stores in Tampa and just kind of looked and held some of the puppies and pet some of the puppies to kind of see. I didn't hold them. I just petted them to see which breed did I feel comfortable with. And I think a dachshund might be around my puppy wheelhouse. Now I'm just like blushing thinking of the puppy that I saw and I want to name him Balthazar. If I do get a dachshund, if we do get a puppy, like when the baby gets a little bit older, I'll maybe get a dachshund and call it Balthazar. That's something I really want to do. So this video really, really, really made me really want a puppy. And now my husband's going to have to hear that for until I forget or until he caves, whichever happens first. But I think her puppy's adorable and her voice is also adorable. So she's talking about the puppy and talking as the puppy when she's like, burp, like, ruff, you know, all of that. Super cute. This video is super adorable. I'm happy for her. Happy for little Mochi. Happy for Sweeto. So I'm really happy for them. I'm happy that they're having a great time. And I hope for many more birthdays to come for little Mochi. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. If you like the video, check out the link in the description box below to support Wolfie Chew. If you like this video, hug the life out of that like button. I love you guys as always. And until next time, buddies. Toodles.